Record of Ragnarok is some of the most hype and badass stuff I have ever laid my eyes upon. You know, guys, I have been sitting here for a couple of minutes now wondering how the hell am I going to introduce Record of Ragnarok to you guys? How am I going to go about talking about this right now? You know, I'm not the most eloquent person out there using all these pretty words to describe series I like. So I decided, fuck it, you know? Record of Ragnarok is just fucking awesome, dude. I can find no other way to explain the hype behind this series, man. It is just pure, unfiltered badassery. Every single chapter is just a testosterone adrenaline booster to your soul. Felt that I grew like 5 feet taller. My dick has grown 8 inches longer just by reading Record of Ragnarok. And if that doesn't interest you, I don't know what will. Now, if you guys follow me on Twitter, you guys know I've been talking a little bit about Record of Ragnarok. I started it a couple of days ago, and I'm already almost caught up right now. I'm not fully caught up. I'm about 9 chapters behind right now. But before I get into actually talking about the specifics about Record of Ragnarok, let me explain a little bit about this series for people who are unfamiliar with it and this is the first time hearing about it. Record of Ragnarok, or Shuumatsu No Valkyrie as it's also known as, is essentially just a huge ass tournament arc between gods and humans. Essentially, the gods have deemed that maybe humans should just be annihilated outright. Maybe mankind just shouldn't exist anymore. Until Brunhild, one of the 13 Valkyries, the eldest sister, you know, basically kind of persuades the gods in a way to, instead of just wiping them out entirely, we basically should hold a 1v1 to the death tournament between gods and notable humans. Best of 7 out of 13 fights to deem whether or not humanity should have the right to live. When I heard this concept, bro, dog, that like literally like the endorphins just fired off in my head. I'm like, bro, this is exactly what I want, man, because I love my tournament arcs, man. Who doesn't love seeing fights, bro? Who doesn't love seeing two buff, overpowered men just go at it at each other to the death, bro? No holds barred, just pedal to the metal action, man. And that is exactly what Record of Ragnarok is. Literally in the first chapter, it introduces the concept, the plot, and literally it introduces the first fight. In the first fucking chapter, bro. I have been reading Record of Ragnarok in the Discord with a couple of my friends recently, and just like, it's been just so much fun to see, like, because most of them have read it already. I'm the only one that hasn't read it, because as you guys know, I'm starting to get into manga slowly but surely. But goddamn, dude, Record of Ragnarok, it's so badass, bro. And just having just other people there, just like seeing everything, like the fights, it's so fucking dope. Now, there's a lot of stuff I really want to go more in depth with Record of Ragnarok, because yes, it essentially is at its core like a tournament arc. Like literally basically all it consists of is fights. Like there's like no downtime at all. Like there's like literally no chapter without any sort of action in it. Like basically it's just like a bunch of chapters and then like the end of the fight and then like maybe like a little bit of downtime, like just like a smidgen of downtime and then right into the next fight. And I love that because it keeps me on the edge of my seat each time. It makes me want to read more. It just keeps me so engaged into the story. Now, some people might be thinking, oh, Record of Ragnarok is just fights, bro, just mindless fighting, you know, like what's the fun in that? Like, won't it become just repetitive over time and stuff like that? Like, where's like, you know, the intrigue? Like, where's the driving plot? And like, while that is a valid claim, another thing I love about Record of Ragnarok is how it's able to actually add weight to the fights, bro, in such a short amount of time. Like, I love how they're able to intertwine the backstory between each fighter while the fight is actually happening, man. Like, it's such a unique talent too, because it's either you can either rush it and like maybe make me not care about the characters much, but I feel like Record of Ragnarok has that like ultra sweet spot, right? Where like I get just enough to know the character and want to either root for them or pray for their downfall when the fight is happening. So even when it's just fight after fight, I feel like each fight has its own weight to it. It has its own arc, like its own character development to it. It has its like own theme and meaning behind each fight, and it's like, it's absolutely incredible. Like I said before, there's going to be a total of 13 fights, best of 7, but I am on fight 5 right now. I believe you guys who are caught up in the manga, at least my friends are telling me right now, you guys are in the middle of fight 6. So I'm really curious to see the continuation of Record of Ragnarok, how it feels to be up to date with a series, because this is the first time I'm ever going to be like, kind of like, you know, waiting monthly for another chapter to come out. So it kind of feels, you know, it feels kind of good to, you know, kind of be involved into it with a series that's, you know, monthly releasing with chapters and whatnot. I'm also trying not to spoil too much right now for the people that do want to go check this series out, because I swear to God, you guys, you know, I always want the best for you, right? I swear to God, you guys will not, if you guys like fights and shonen and stuff like that, you know, we cover a lot of like shonen stuff on the channel. I know that, but trust me, guys, if you guys have not read Record of Ragnarok, please do yourself a favor and do that. It's like literally, it's literally everything I want from like a tournament arc fighting type of manga, right? Like, it's so fucking badass. But like, I'm trying my best not to spoil right now for the people that do want to go check it out. What I plan to do, I really want to go more in depth into the actual series itself, like the fights, the characters, certain plot points and whatnot. Like, I kind of want to, like, you know, do different videos on it, but I kind of want to leave this video just like, you know, my general impressions and thoughts on the series overall. Everybody, I'm not gonna lie, bro, it's pretty hard to find different words to explain, you know, my thoughts and opinions on this series without using words like high, badass, dope, cool as fuck. Everyone in this manga is so damn cool, bro. I would say, like, I guess there's technically like no bad guys. I guess you could call the gods bad guys, right? If you are, we're human, right? So I guess like technically we all would root for the human side, right? But like, even if like the gods are the bad guys, they're so badass too. Same with the humans, bro. Like, dude, like, take fucking Jack the Ripper, for example, dude. One of the most infamous serial killers in all of mankind. Probably my favorite character. I know that seems kind of weird out of context. You're like, what the fuck, Ivory? You like a serial killer? Bro, this dude is the living definition of the GOAT, man. Jack the Ripper is so damn cool, bro. Thor, bro, he might be on the god side, but goddamn, that boy is so fucking cool. I love the designs of the gods too. I love Record of Ragnarok's take on certain mythical, you know, beings like Nordic gods, you know, Hinduism and stuff like that. It's so dope. I know Record of Ragnarok isn't like the first series to kind of like take like historical beings and put them in like a arena type matchup. I know the Fate series has done this as well, but like the Fate Jack the Ripper versus Record of Ragnarok Jack the Ripper, it's literally night and day, bro. I just gotta say that. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, like, before reading Record of Ragnarok, I never could have imagined, how the hell do you read a fight, you know, words on screen without any type of animation and stuff like that? I'm like, dude, that's like impossible, and people want me to react to manga and whatnot. Like, how the hell am I supposed to do that? Until I read this and I'm like, hold on, this shit kind of slaps, bro. I'm like, dude, I'm sorry, bro. I can rant about Record of Ragnarok all day. This series is so fucking badass, dude. And I am aware that an anime for it did get announced, and it's supposed to be releasing sometime in June. I know Netflix is gonna be kind of the licensor behind it or whatnot. It's gonna be released on Netflix, and I know a lot of people kind of want my opinions on that. Are you gonna react to it? Or yeah, yada yada, all this stuff. I kind of want to save that for a different video. I want to talk about it because this isn't the first time I'm ever gonna be going into an anime with manga knowledge already, knowing what happens beforehand, seeing how it's adapted and whatnot. I feel like that'll be an interesting video to see. I guess, you know, my impressions on the anime. I do want to talk about it, like the trailer and stuff like that, my opinions beforehand, but I want to leave that for a different video. Same thing with others, like another video I want to do. I kind of want to like rank different characters and stuff like that. And I know everyone has their favorite. I got mine and stuff like that, but I kind of want to just do different stuff. I don't know, dude. This series has kind of just, it's captured me, bro. Like, I fucking love this series. It's just so fucking cool. I need to find a different word. Someone come up with a different word, but cool, badass, hype, sick as fuck, dope, any other synonym but those words, bro, please. But yeah, everybody, I don't know about you, but I think I fully conveyed how I feel about this series overall. It's just, this series is so fucking cool. It's so hype, man. Please do yourself a favor, do yourself a justice. And if you love, you know, your tournament arc, just a 1v1, people going at it to the death, nonstop action, pedal to the metal, just, you know, pure adrenaline, bro. If you love that stuff, if that sounds interesting to you, no hesitation, please go check out Record of Ragnarok if you haven't already. But for the people that have read it, I hope you guys, you know, agree with my opinions on it. You agree with my thoughts. Like I said, I didn't want to get too in-depth with it right now, but, you know, I kind of wanted to talk about it a little bit. But don't worry, I'm definitely going to be making a couple more videos on Record of Ragnarok because, obviously, the manga is still ongoing. I want to, you know, keep up to date with it. There's a lot more stuff I want to go into, like key plot points and whatnot, but for the people that watched this video and made it this far, thank you so much. I appreciate you guys from the bottom of my heart, man. Oh, also, before I leave you guys right now, I just gotta let you guys know that Adam is the fucking GOAT, and he will always remain the GOAT for the rest of my fucking life, dude. I love that boy Adam to death, bro. God damn, I love that man, dude. But anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this video, man. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, guys. It's super easy. It takes like 1 second. Of course, you guys can always change your mind later. Also, leave in the comments down below. Let me know your opinions on Record of Ragnarok and like that and all that stuff. Let me know like suggestions you would want me to do involving Record of Ragnarok or just other manga in general, man. You know, let me know if this is your first time hearing about Record of Ragnarok 2. And also, guys, follow me on Twitter if you haven't already. That's where, you know, I post all my updates and whatnot. I talk about certain stuff, like I was talking about Record of Ragnarok on Twitter too. You know, I keep up to date with all that stuff. But other than that, everybody, it's been your boy Ivory, man, and I'm out. Peace.